Hi, in this video we'll see how to work with maps in Tableau. Maps are basically geographical representation of your data. Sometimes if you are bored of using this bar charts, column charts or tree maps, anything, you can take in consideration using this maps. But when should the maps be used in your Tableau? Maps can be used when you have the geographical dimensions, like you have the state, city, country, territory, anything like that. So that time you can use these options as maps. It makes your data represent in a much more beautiful manner, and you can analyze easily with that data itself. Now, what are the different types of maps which I'll be showing you in this video is, now first of all, I'm working into a file named as Getting Started with Maps, and I've used the Global Superstore 2017. That's a database which I've used. You can download this file below this video. There's a link given. You can download and you can use it that place. Now, what are the things I'll be showing you? I'll be showing you how to work with state-wise profit. I can show you with the help of maps. Also, how do we work with state-wise profit? You can see the statewide profit. Symbol maps with circles. And how do I create symbol maps with shapes? These are the shapes which you can create it. So let us see first one. If I do not use the maps and if I represent my data in the form of this bar charts or column charts, how will it look like? So first of all, I'll clear this data. And now what I can do is I can pick up the state into this columns and I'll say as add all members. I'll pick up this sales and put into this rows. Okay. So if you see, that's a column chart which is prepared here. I'll make into this descending order. So these are different states which are given and the sales are in the descending order. So this is one method. Otherwise, if you want, you can just swap the fields and you can see these are the sales of different states in this place. So rather than using this one, if I use this method, where all the states are given and all the cities are given, and I can show the sales state wise, city wise, or the profit, this would look much more easier, and it can help you analyze the data in a much more better manner. So whenever you have to represent data geographically, always remember you should go for this maps itself in Tableau. Let us see how do I create the next one. So instead of using this without maps bar chart, column chart, I suggest you can go with this map charts. Now, the very first example, I'll show you how to create a map that is state-wise profit itself. So first of all, I'll clear this everything on this place, right? Now, remember, whenever you want to create a map graph, you should have some geographical dimension. For example, you have a state here and see the globe symbol which is given. If I scroll on the top here on this place, I have another given as city and country. These are globe symbol. These are the dimensions which are given. This are required if you want to create a map graph. How do I understand? If you just click on this show me bar, and if you click on this place, and if you observe here for filled maps, try, these are the things you need. You need minimum one geo or dimensions, that is geographical dimensions, zero or more dimensions, zero or more bases. Same way, if I click on the left hand side, it says you need minimum geographical dimension itself. So that is the requirement which you have. Now, there's a very simple method by which you can create within 10 seconds any maps. I repeat, you can create in just 10 seconds. So what I'll do is, I'll give you a simple example here. I have the state dimension at this place. If I want to create a map with respect to this state, very simple is you just double click on this state like this. When you double click on the state, you get automatically this map graph because I've done the automatic settings, which is early. By default, it is given by Tableau. So you don't have to do anything. Just double click on the state. A latitude and longitude would be generated, which will help you represent your data at this place. Now, this is just, the states which are given, and these are the dots which says these are the states here. Now, if you want to say, as I said, I want to show you state-wise profit. If you want to show state-wise profit, pick up the profit and you can drop into this colors part. Now, if you observe, these are the profits in all these states. What do I understand with the help of these colors? So on the right hand side, if you see, there's a legend given. It says the dark blue color means highest profit. The yellow color means it is the lowest profit. So dark blue color is this area. This is given here. And the lowest one, you can see this one is area. I don't know the names of these areas. If you are creating a graph or map from some other thing, you should know the names also. So if you want to learn the names of the states, pick up the states and put into the labels, or you can call it a text. So when you put in the labels, now you can see the region names are given as California, Washington, Montana, and all these names are given easily itself. So what I've done is I pick up the state and I put into the labels part. If you also want to understand what is the sales done at every place, now you can pick up the sales and drop into this labels itself. So if you press this one, now along with California, you're getting the sales which are done in California. and all the regions at this place. Sometimes if you think it is getting more complicated, remove whatever you want. I'll just remove this option as sum of sales, which is nothing but a label. If you see, that's a label symbol. If I remove this, label will go away. If you want to remove this state label, you can just remove this also outside like this and it will go away. So this is very simple by which you can create state wise profit. Now I'll show you how to create state wise sales. Click on this sheet. This is already created, but I'll show you how to create from scratch. Close it. Remember, 10 seconds are more than enough to create this kind of graph. So first is double click on the states. Second is pick up the sales and you can drop into these colors. That's it, done. So within 10 seconds, you have created this kind of map chart which says the sales are given here. And if you see, that's the sales. The light blue color means low sales, the dark blue color means higher sales, which is very easy to understand. Now, let's see the next one. If I have symbol maps with circles, if you want to create symbol maps with circles, how do I create it? So for that, it's very simple. I'll just click on this clear sheet everything. Double click on this state and this is nothing but symbol maps with circles. By default, if you see, these are the circles which are given here. Now, how do I come to know it's circles? If I click on this drop down, it says automatically using visualization query language, Tableau will choose the appropriate graph itself. So right now it has selected as circles. If I say I want to convert into shapes, now these are the different shapes which are given. So if you want to change the shapes at this place, you can just click on this place and you can just keep on selecting the shapes from this place. If I just keep on selecting the shapes, if you observe here, these are the shapes which are selected. So it's very simple and easy. I've shown you what I was supposed to show in the next sheet, symbol maps with shapes. So here I've created, these are the shapes. If you want to change the shape, select this shape, click on more shapes, click on this drop down. These are the loads of shapes which are given. If you want to understand more about these shapes which I've taken, that is nothing but changing the shapes, please see the video of the marks below that section. You have this shape option. So I'll select this option as letters. I'll select as B, apply, okay. And if you see everywhere, it is written as B symbol. The size is very less. If you want to increase the size, click on this drop down and increase the size. You see, that's the size which has increased. Anytime if you want to change the shape, click on this place and it will keep on changing. So that is nothing but shown as symbol maps with the different shapes part itself. So it's very simple and very easy to create different maps. That is a geographical representation. In this video, what we have seen is working without the maps, working state-wise profit, state-wise sales, symbol maps with circles and symbol maps with different shapes. I hope you have understood. That's all for this video.